Hey, Brandon Steele with ChiroUp. I want to go over a new thing that I just learned this month in Journal of Physical Therapy and Sport. It changes just a little bit of our shoulder rehab, but I think it changes it for the better. It's simple for me to understand as a practitioner, and also simple for our patients to understand, which helps in their compliance. That is the ability to, instead of retract their scapula when they're going through exercises, to posteriorly tilt the scapula. Let me explain that first. What we used to do is we used to bring the shoulder back into retraction or have the person pinch their shoulder blades together. That helps with scapular stability and helps diminish shoulder pain. However, it's really reinforcing a pathological process. That person's not bringing their shoulder blades back. They're not able to go through normal scapular motion when they're performing any kind of glenohumeral range of motion. So instead, what we can do is we can use posterior tilt of the scapula. Some people might call that scapular setting. What you're going to do is you're going to teach your patient to, instead of bringing their shoulder blades together, now they're actually going to bring the shoulder blade down and relax. And watch my finger right here on top of the acromion. As she brings her shoulder blade down, it's moving backward. Well, as it turns out, there's an ancillary benefit to performing that maneuver, and that is increasing the subacromial space. And if we can increase the subacromial space, it'll take some pressure and some irritation away from that supraspinatus. Not many people come in to see us for scapular dyskinesis, but there's a lot of patients who come in for impingement syndrome. So this is going to help improve that, that space and hopefully take away some of their pain. Here's a second benefit, is that when your patient does some posterior tilt of the scapula, that's going to preferentially activate the serratus anterior. So now when she's bringing her arm up into abduction or shoulder flexion, she's preferentially activating the right muscle that's supposed to be activated for normal scapular upward rotation. So we get two great benefits with just this little small change in our patient education and also our hopeful patient resolution of symptoms. We've already incorporated this in our rehabilitation exercise in ChiroUp. I hope this helps, and then I'll send out the actual the blog and the abstract with the journal article for your review.